Yes, good evening to all. The last class I explained about extent of reaction. Based on the numerical value of Kc, we can able to predict the extent of reaction. When Kc value is more than 10 Q, reaction in which products are more than reactants. Products are predominant over the reactants. If Kc value less than 10⁻³, reactants are predominant over the products. Whenever, if you see the Kc value in between 10⁻³ to 10⁻³, then we can say that appreciable concentrations of reactants and products both are present. Neither will be greater. Both will be present when Kc value in between 10⁻³ to 10⁻³. When Kc value is exactly 1, the reaction is at equilibrium. Okay. Next, second application is predicting the direction of reaction. Predicting the direction of reaction. So we can able to predict the direction also by using the Kc value. As we predicted the extent of reaction, similarly we can predict the direction of reaction also. So how do we predict the direction? So here we are taking one different we are introducing another quantity, that is reaction coefficient. We already know Kc. Kc is what? Equilibrium constant at with respect to molar concentration. We can express the Kc value only at equilibrium. But other than equilibrium, if you want to express the reaction concentration, product concentration, we can explain or we can express based on one quantity, that is reaction coefficient. Reaction coefficient that is set with QC. What is this? Reaction coefficient QC. What is QC? QC is, this is expression of molar concentrations of reactants and products at any instant of time. Need not to be at equilibrium. Okay, if you want to write Kc, when do you write Kc? Only at equilibrium you can write Kc. Apart from equilibrium, we can't write Kc. Equilibrium constant we cannot able to express with respect to molar concentration. But at any point of time, other than equilibrium, at any point of time, if you want to express molar concentrations, we can write QC. I'll tell you a simple example. I'll write here. A plus B gives rise to C plus D. Okay. For this QC, how I'll write? QC is product concentration by reactant concentration. This is QC. But for same reaction, I can also write Kc. Kc is molar concentration of products by molar concentration of reactants. Can I tell you what is the major difference between these two? I have written Qc and Kc. Both expressions are same. But what is the main difference? Qc is not at equilibrium. Is not at equilibrium. At any point, at any instant of time, at any instant of time, at any instant of time, we can write QC. But QC must be at equilibrium. Okay, not only QC, KC, C, D, A, B concentrations. Here also C, D, A, B concentrations. C, D, A, B. These concentrations are, AB. Okay, so these concentrations are at equilibrium. Concentration of products by concentrated reactant. Concentration of A, B, C, D are at equilibrium. But concentration of A, B, C, D are not at equilibrium. Understood? There is a main difference between QC and KC. So by using these values, QC value, KC value, we can predict the direction of reaction. This direction we can able to predict by using the numerical value of QC and KC. Okay, write this. Completed? Okay. Now, here, see, like previous case, extent of reaction, here also we have three cases. First one, first point is, if QC less than KC, comparing to QC, if KC is more, that means that the reaction proceeds in forward direction. We are explaining the direction here. Okay. Proceeds in forward direction if QC less than KC. Second case, if QC greater than KC, then the reaction proceeds in backward direction. Proceeds in backward direction. If both are same, can you tell me if QC is equal to KC, what happens? If QC is equal to KC, reaction, we cannot say that reaction is not possible. Reaction is there, but reaction is at equilibrium. Then reaction is already at equilibrium. It will not proceed neither forward nor backward. Is at equilibrium if both are equal. Okay. So this diagrammatically, it is given in NCERT. If you see this, this is QC, this is KC. Okay, QC less than KC forward. QC greater than KC backward. This is backward. If both are equal, QC is equal to KC, reaction is at equilibrium. Understood? Okay, we'll solve the problems now. Write a problems. Problem I'll write. For the reaction, H2 plus I2 gives rise to 2HI. KC is 57. KC is 57. And the concentrations of H2, I2 and HI at a time are given as, continue the problem, 0.1 m, is it visible? And 0.2 m and 0.4 m, respectively. Respectively. So question is, in which direction reaction proceeds? In which direction reaction proceeds? So here one reaction is given, H2 plus I2 gives rise to 2HI, Kc is given. And the concentration of H2, I2, HI at a particular time, at maybe any point of time, they are given the values. H2 concentration is 0.1, I2 concentration is 0.2, and HI concentration 0.4 respectively. In which direction reaction proceeds? Yes, very good. QC value, how much you will get? 8. If QC is 8, which is less than KC, so reaction proceeds in? No. Yes. Yes, QC less than KC, you will get forward direction. Okay. So now calculate. So what you have to do is simple. Okay, so what you have to do is, for the given reaction, find out QC. So how do you write QC for the given reaction? Same like KC you write. Same like KC. QC is equal to HI concentration square by H2 into I2. HI is what? 0.4 whole square by 0.1 into 0.2. We'll get around 8. Correct? We'll get 8. So QC less than KC, because QC is 8, KC is 57. So therefore, reaction proceeds in forward direction. Yes. Another question I'll write to find out. This is problem 1, problem 2. The value of Kc for the reaction. The value of Kc KC for the reaction, 2A gives rise to B plus C, is 2 into 10 power minus 3. 2 into 10 power minus 3. At a given time, concentration of A, concentration of B, and concentration of C are equal, that is 3 into 10 power minus 4 m. In which direction reaction proceeds? So here again the same problem. Okay. Yes. QC how much you'll get? 1. Correct. Same like this problem, find out QC. QC is equal to, for this reaction, concentration of B into concentration of C by concentration of A whole square. Okay. So all concentrations are equal. All concentrations are equal. That is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 8. That is 3 into 10 power minus 4. 3 into 10 power minus 4 by A also same concentration. 3 into 10 power minus 4 whole square. right? All gets cancelled. These two gets cancelled. You'll get one. QC is equal to one. So here, QC greater than KC. Because KC value is what? 2 into 10 power minus 3. 2 into 10 power minus 3 is a small value comparing to 1. So reaction proceeds in backward. Backward. Soundarya? Yes or no? Backward or forward? Okay. Next problem. Next problem is that's it. We'll continue the next concept. Okay. So understood, there are two main applications of equilibrium constant. We can explain the, or we can predict the extent of reaction. We can predict the direction also. Forward or backward, that we can predict by using the QC and KC values. Okay. Now write down. Next topic, relationship between equilibrium constant and Gibbs energy. Relationship between equilibrium constant and Gibbs energy. So actually, from thermodynamics, we have one formula. Delta G naught is equal to delta G plus RT log QC. That is basic fundamental formula from thermodynamics. So I'll write that formula directly. But actually, we know that we know from thermodynamics. Sorry. So normally for spontaneous reaction, delta G less than zero. For non-spontaneous reactions, delta G greater than zero. For equilibrium reaction, delta G is equal to zero. That is the basic fundamental points that we already discussed in chemical equilibrium chapter. Okay. So I write an equation, delta G naught is equal to delta G plus RT ln QC. Okay, so we will use this equation. At equilibrium, we are going to derive the expression at equilibrium constant. When we can use KCE? When the reaction is at equilibrium. So we have to write the equilibrium conditions and we have to substitute in this formula so that we can derive an expression, equilibrium constant and Gibbs energy. At equilibrium, delta G naught is equal to, what happens? You tell me. Sorry, delta G is equal to delta G naught. Delta G is equal to delta G naught. Correction. Delta G is equal to delta G naught plus RT ln QC. At equilibrium, delta G value is what? Very good. Zero. And QC is equal to? QC is equal to? Just now I told expressions. QC is equal to KC. Where? At equilibrium. Yes or no? At equilibrium, delta G is equal to zero, QC is equal to KC. Substitute delta G value, QC value in this formula. So what you'll get? So zero is equal to delta G naught plus RT ln QC. Okay, here you can write in the heading standard. We write here standard Gibbs energy. Standard Gibbs energy andre delta G naught. Delta G naught is standard Gibbs energy. Delta G naught is standard Gibbs energy. So we'll substitute in this. So delta G is equal to zero. Delta G naught plus RT ln KC. So from this, RT ln KC is equal to delta G naught. Okay. So ln KC is equal to delta G naught by RT minus. Sorry, minus you'll get. Right? Yes. Negative. Negative will get. So ln KC, KC what I can write? We have a simple formula, that is ln x base 10 is equal to A. If ln x base 10 is equal to A, ln E. So what I can write? X is equal to e power A. Ln x base e is equal to A, x is equal to e power A. Okay, based on that formula, so this is ln. This is base E. Ln x base E is equal to delta minus delta G naught by RT. So from this KC, what you'll write here, KC, KC is equal to E power minus delta G naught by RT. This is the formula, relation between KC and delta G naught. Okay. Now this equation I can also write like this. I can also write here, that is, we know that ln is equal to 2.303 log. Ln is equal to 2.303 log. I replace this ln value with log. So what I can write? So 2.303 log base 10 KC is equal to minus delta G naught by RT. So from this KC, what I can write? KC is equal to e power. I'll add one step here. There is log KC base 10 is equal to minus delta G naught by 2.303 RT. Correct? So from this KC, what I can write? E power. Sorry, not E. I have one more formula. Log X base 10 is equal to A. X is equal to 10 power A. Correct? So based on what I can write? Log x base 10 is equal to A. X is equal to 10 power minus delta G naught by 2.303 RT. So write it here, 10 power minus delta G naught by 2.303 RT. Understood? We can write any these two expressions. So these expressions also important. Okay, so delta G naught is equal to minus RT ln KC, or delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303 RT log KC. Okay, R KC is equal to e power minus delta G naught by RT, R KC is equal to 10 power minus delta G naught by 2.303 RT. Is it clear? Understood? So you have to remember the conclusions. Now I'll write the conclusions. Remember these formulas, this formula and this formula. Okay, these two formulas we use while solving the numericals. Now conclusions I'll write here based on this expression. You see, first one, I'll take this expression. Any one expression I can take, I'll take this. If delta G naught is less than zero, if delta G naught value less than zero means what? Negative. If I substitute negative here, negative, negative, positive. So total value becomes positive. If total value becomes positive, KC becomes greater than one. Kc becomes greater than 1. If Kc greater than 1, then the reaction proceeds in forward direction, and this reaction is spontaneous reaction. Where this reaction is spontaneous. So repeat once again. Delta G naught value, if it is negative, positive. So total this value becomes positive. That is Kc greater than 1. If Kc greater than 1, delta G naught less than 0, that reaction proceeds in forward direction. That reaction also said to be spontaneous. Second condition. If delta G naught value greater than 0, greater than 0 means what? Positive. If it is a positive, total value becomes negative only. In that case, we can write Kc less than 1. If Kc less than 1, we can write the reaction proceeds in backward direction. And this type of reaction is non-spontaneous. Non-spontaneous reaction. Understood? Write it. Okay. So no need to by heart these formulas. Just remember how we got this formula and all. Okay. If delta G is equal to 0, Kc is equal to 1, what? If Kc is equal to 1, delta G naught is equal to 0, then it is equilibrium. Okay. So Kc is equal to 1 is equilibrium. I already written the last topic. That's why I'm not writing here. Okay. Next, write a problem. Hydrolysis of sucrose sucrose undergo hydrolysis. We are getting glucose plus fructose. Equilibrium constant Kc for the reaction. Equilibrium constant Kc is 2 into 10 cube at 300 Kelvin. Calculate delta G naught. Kc value is given. They are asking to find out delta G naught. Relation is what? Delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303 RT log Kc. That formula you apply. So if you get log 2 value, there you can substitute. Log 2 is equal to 0.30. Log 2 value 0.30. So formula is delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303 RT log Kc. Substitute in this minus 2.303 R value what you will take? Gibbs energy whenever you are having energy, we are take R value in joules. Joules is 8.314. temperature is given 300 log of 2 into 10 cube minus 17.2. No, not 17. Check it once. So this total value, if you multiply, you will get minus 5744.13. Okay, 14. If you multiply all this value, yes, minus 1723. No. Okay, so remaining is what? Log A into B. Log A into B formula. Log A plus log B. So log 2 plus log 10 cube. This we had to expand. Log A into B. Log A into B is log A plus log B. Log 2 plus log 10 cube. Okay. No, Prajwal. You see. So I'll simplify minus 5744.14 into log 2 value written here 0.30 plus log 10 cube 3 log 10 base 10. So here I can write log x power m is equal to m log x. The formula. Log x power m is equal to m log x. It is a formula. This is one formula. So log AB is equal to log A plus log B. It is a formula. It is A. This is A. This is B. Okay. Log A into B. Log A into B formula. Log A plus log B. No. Not 18,000. I'll simplify. Listen. So here minus 5744.14 is equal to 0.30 3 log 10 base 10. Log 10 base 10 value is always 1. Log 10 base 10 value is 1. Log 10 base 10, 1. So I write 1 here. 1 into 3. 3 is there. 3 into 1. So minus 5744.14, 3.30. 3 na 30 na ma? 3 ne. Yes. Sorry, it is not 3, 13 ma. You make it 13, this is. NCERT problem, 2 into 10 power 13. Here also you'll get 13. You'll get 13. Okay. Here 13, 13, 13. Okay. It is 13. Yes. I did a mistake. Actually, I have given you 10 cube. That's why you may be getting the definite answer. Okay. So make it 10 power 13. Now simplify what you will get. Minus 76397 joules or minus 76.3 kilojoules. Yes, correct. Meda. Yes, ma, correct. Okay. So don't worry, log formula sandal, I'll tell you once. Ionic equilibrium, in ionic equilibrium, we have so many logarithm formulas. There I'll teach you once, what are the logarithm formulas, how to apply that formulas. Okay, once I'll teach you there, then we'll go to the problems there. Okay, one formula we got here, that's why I'm writing here. Okay, in ionic equilibrium, we have to calculate the pH values. There I'll tell you logarithm formulas. Okay, so understood the problem? minus. We have to write minus. Okay, I'll tell you. Write out. Write another problem. The equilibrium constant for the following reaction. For the following reaction is N2 plus O2 gives us 2NO 5 × 10⁴ calculate the standard enthalpy, standard Gibbs energy. Gibbs energy at 373 Kelvin. At 373 Kelvin. Okay, same formula you apply delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303 log Kc. Log phi value I'll write. Log phi value is 0.69. Log phi value 0.69. So minus 2.303, R value 8.314, temperature becomes 600. Log 5 × 10⁴. How much you got? 3349.5. Yes, minus. Minus you are right. Okay. Yes, correct. That's it. Here we have this total, you multiply. If you multiply all these values, how much you will get? Into is log A into B. Again, we had to expand there. Log A into B is log A plus log B. Log 5 plus log 10⁴. So minus 11488.2. Log 5 is 0.69. The 4 log 10 base 10. So log 10 base 10 is 1. So log 10 base 10 value 1. So 0.69 plus 4 × 1. So there 11488.2, 4.69. Right? Here 373 is given, no? Oh, sorry. I taken, I thought that it is a degree Celsius. Is it Kelvin, no? Sorry. Then it becomes different. Seven, one, four, one. 7141 you will get. Yes. So if you see, final answer is what? -33495 joules or -33.49 kilo joules. Okay. Is it audible? Okay. Next, last concept in chemical equilibrium part, that is Le-Chatelier principle. Very important concept, Le-Chatelier principle. Okay, so Le-Chatelier principle. Okay, so what Le-Chatelier principle explains actually? If we take any reversible reaction, A gives rise to B. It is a reversible reaction. A gives rise to B. For this reaction, it is actually in reverse equilibrium condition. Rate of forward reaction becomes equal to rate of backward reaction. But we can increase the speed of forward reaction by decreasing the backward. Or we can increase the rate of backward reaction by decreasing the forward reaction. So means rate of forward reaction we can increase, backward reaction we can make it slow. Or rate of backward reaction we can increase, rate of forward reaction becomes slow. Then we can change the equilibrium position by doing some changes in the equilibrium conditions. That is, we can change the concentration of reactants or concentration of products. We can increase the temperature or decrease the temperature. We can increase the pressure or decrease the pressure. So by doing this change in concentration of reactants and products, change in temperature, change in pressure. So all this process, whenever you change all these properties and all, equilibrium position will changes. Equilibrium position will changes. Equilibrium position shift more towards forward, less towards backward. Here more towards backward, less towards forward. So this type of changes we can do by changing the concentration of reactants, product, temperature and pressure. So that type of effect was studied by according to the Le-Chatelier principle. Okay, first let me write statement. You write the statement first. it states that I'll dictate right down. If a system at equilibrium, is subjected to change, in temperature, comma pressure, or concentration, the equilibrium position, is shifted, shifted, shifted to that side, where, the effect of change, is nullified, I repeat once again, if a system at equilibrium, is subjected to a change in temperature, comma pressure, or concentration, the equilibrium position, is shifted to that side, where the effect of change, is nullified. Effect of change is nullified. NULLIFIED. Written. Have you written the definition? Okay. So the definition, what it says is, this is an equilibrium. If now is it audible? Okay. So next point you write.